Hello, on the left is my 2.02 meter world's largest Rubik's cube, and on the right is my 5.6 millimeter world's smallest cube. As you can see, there's quite a size difference, or maybe you can't see. The small cube would fit inside the large one around 47 million times. Both puzzles are very awkward and slow to move for completely different reasons, so let's see how they compare by running the same sequence of moves side by side. I've speeded this up 5 times, as I've shown similar moves to before. When I filmed these, I wasn't going as fast as I could, so it won't be totally accurate, but it gives you an idea. Although I hold the official world record for the smallest cube, I didn't apply for it. That's because all I did was take a 3D printed 6mm cube designed by Callum and shave 1/5 of a millimetre from each side with a knife. The cubies aren't even the same size, and Callum did the clever bit. Guinness saw my video and suggested that I apply for the record. I said no, but they gave it to me anyway, without even any evidence. I'm not really complaining, but people should know that I don't really deserve it. Naturally, I feel that I do deserve the record for the biggest cube, at least until someone beats it. So the tiny one was faster, but not by a huge amount. Here you can see a size comparison with a US dime, British penny and EU 10 cents. Plus the giant cube, of course. Here's some comparisons with other puzzles. On the ground is my world's largest master pyramid from 2016. It has an edge of 52 centimetres or 1 foot 8 inches. Most of my other giant puzzles are now sold or disposed of. I would never throw away a moderately big plastic puzzle, but things like my floppy cube and 2x2, which are made from cardboard, would have rotted and were simply too big to keep. I do, however, still own my collection of tiny puzzles. This is my 5.6mm Rubik's Cube again, my custom 19mm 3x3 barrel from 2008, the world's smallest mass-produced Rubik's Cube by Maru with an edge of 15mm, my Siamese 19mm cubes from 2008, my 19mm Fisher Cube from 2008, a 20mm 3D printed world's smallest 4x4 cube by Evgeny from 2011, a 15mm ball I made from a Maru 15mm cube in 2015, a similar ball though a bit bigger at 19mm, Evgeny's world's smallest Halpern Mayer pyramid at 20mm from 2011, my world's smallest Tetraminx from 2010, made from Evgeny's world's smallest pyraminx, Matt Banner's 34mm world's smallest 7x7 from 2014, a 54mm world's smallest mass-produced 6x6 from 2019, Greg Fenwick's 15mm world's smallest master pentultimate from 2014, my 23mm world's smallest scube made from a Meffetz mini scube in 2009, and my world's smallest 2x2x3 at 32mm long, also from 2009. And finally, the puzzle I haven't compared it to yet, a regular Rubik's Cube. A standard 57mm cube would fit inside my giant one over 44,000 times. A regular cube has over 43 quintillion permutations, whereas my giant cube has exactly the same, obviously. If you would like to see me solve my giant one, then check out my description for a link. If it's not there yet, it will be later in December. coloured material I'm standing on is a tarpaulin. It protects the cube when I'm sliding it around or turning it over. I need it to be slippery, but when I filmed this in November, it became damp and far more slippery than I wanted. Unfortunately, what happened next was missed, but I think you can work it out. This is the first time in 10 years I have slipped over, and it would have made a great ending. No, I wasn't hurt. Unfortunately, some might say.